produced from all of her glosses and oils are handmade. She's actually done videos where she talks about how she makes her glosses and her lip oils and how she packages them and everything. So I highly recommend checking her out first. Before I get into the individual glosses, I wanted to review the packaging itself. So the packaging of the glosses are just a regular generic lip gloss tube, but you could see at the bottom she now includes the amount of product in there, which is 8 milliliters of gloss, and it is a very thick gloss, so a little does go a long way. So yeah, and then before this, she used to have, the glosses would come in like little tubes and like squeeze tubes, and now obviously she's gotten rid of all those. I like this packaging better, I would say. I just think it looks like nicer. But yeah, she did, that was like her really, her old packaging. And then, sometimes the caps are not white, sometimes they're like a different color, but the ones I got just happened to have white caps. And then when you remove the gloss, it is a doe foot applicator, so it catches a lot of product, but it also doesn't get ruined over time like a brush would get ruined over time. So it does have the doe foot applicator, and it's pretty big because the tube is pretty big. And then my only complaint, and this is more about the packaging than anything else, is that, so it's not like really her fault, but this little cap that you can see that you get, sometimes it like pops off and you have to put it back in there, and that is annoying because when it pops off, it like, the gloss comes out because it's like, it, that's the purpose of it, to prevent the gloss from like coming out when you take the applicator out. So that is a bit annoying, but that's not really your fault. That's just, you know, the way that this is built. I've noticed that happens sometimes with nail polish too. It's just like a defect in packaging. And then another thing is, because the gloss is so thick, sometimes it's kind of hard to close and you really have to like push down on the cap, but it's not that bad. Then she puts the labels in the bottom, and this one is in Molten Brownie. So yeah, that is my review for the packaging. So now I will get into the oils and their packaging. These are in little glass bottles, and they do look smaller, but I don't know if they are officially. Take the cap off, and it's a rollerball, which I'm not a fan of, but I understand why she did it, because they're basically liquid, so if she were to do anything else, like, it wouldn't work. My complaint, after having this on for a while, it leaves a very drying effect on her lips that I don't get from the glosses. It's almost like the oil absorbs in your lips, and then you're left with this like weirdness, whereas gloss is less absorbent. So I don't love the formula of these, but they're very aesthetically pleasing, so I will give her that. The glosses, on the other hand, I love those, and you know, whatever. My only main complaint is that sometimes though, she'll like come out with things, like certain scents, and she won't say that they're limited edition, and then she stops making them after they sell out. So I wish she would be more clear, like, hey, this isn't going to be available anymore, so you should buy it because, you know, I'm going to stop making it. So I wish she would do that. But overall, I love the product. Yeah, I'm not going to swatch these because they're honestly mostly sheer. that's this baby. The next gloss that I purchased was Cheesecake Dreams. So this is like, I'm pretty sure, like strawberry cheesecake flavored. And she has begun marbling her lip glosses. So this is one of the marbled glosses. And as you can see at the bottom, it's like a really pale nude. And at the top, it's As expected, it's very liquidy, which I'm not a fan of. oils, despite having pigment, are pretty sheer. Like, pretty much no color comes off. So if you're looking for color, this ain't it. So now I'm gonna try out this flavor and scent and see what I think. Okay, guys. I smell like a Swedish fish kind of vibe going on. So I don't know, maybe I'm completely wrong there, but I really like this scent. Alright, you guys. So I hope that you have enjoyed this video, and I will be linking her store below as well as her ASMR channel. So stay tuned for more review videos. I will definitely be reviewing her fall